Hi, good morning. Welcome to our laboratory session. Today we are know about the experiment called as Stewart Geese experiment. What is the basic aim of this experiment? The basic aim of this experiment is verify a current carrying conductor produces magnetic field. This phenomenon is verified from this experiment, and we are calculated magnetic induction developed by a current carrier coil or conductor, and is measured with the apparatus called as Stewart Geese apparatus. In this experiment we have a circuit diagram, and the circuit diagram basically contains coil where it is carrying the current, and deflection magnetometer DMM, and a circuit connected with battery, rheostat, plug key and ammeter will provide the required amount of current passing through the coil. And this circuit is power circuit, electric current supply circuit, and this is called as a coil circuit, and these two are connected with the common connector where it is called as a commutator C. The commutator C has four plugs, and among that two opposite plugs point is connected to coil, and remaining two points, one connection is given to rheostat upper terminal, and rheostat another terminal is connected to battery positive, and battery negative to plug key to ammeter, ammeter to another point on the commutator opposite to the rheostat connection. This circuit is over. What we are doing here, we send a certain amount of current with the help of rheostat. On changing the rheostat, the amount of strength what we required, that can be sent through the coil by changing the rheostat. And suitable to current, to note the current, what is the amount of current we need, ammeter A, where it is connected here. So through ammeter, how much current is sending through the coil is measured. And here the magnetic coil carrying the current, and round to the coil, side to the coil, the magnetic induction is developed. The magnetic induction developed at several points along the axis of a coil is calculated by the magnetic induction formulas, where it is called B is equal to BE tan theta. Here BE means earth magnetic field, because we are taking the deflection magnetometer is adjusting in tan A position. What is the meaning of tan A position? Here this scale is now called as an arms of deflection magnetometer. The arms of deflection magnetometer is directed in east and west. So the coil is perpendicular to east west, means the coil is showing in the direction of north south of the earth. And this adjustment is called as a tan A adjustment. At this tan A adjustment, the magnetic induction developed perpendicular to the coil is calculated, given by tangent formula B is equal to BE tan theta. Here we are adjusting the deflection magnetometer respective to the earth's magnetic field. That is why we are taking earth's magnetic field induction BE, whose value is 0.382 × 10⁻⁴ Tesla. Theta is a deflection in the deflection magnetometer. Also, the same value is calculated from experiment by changing at several distances. Suppose the distance is 3 cm, 6 cm, 9 cm, 12 cm, at several distances called as x. At several distances x, we are measuring the deflection. The deflection is named as the theta, and substituting the theta value in this equation, BE tan theta, so we get B. This is called as an experimental value, and theoretically you are also calculated the experimental magnetic induction B, mu naught N I A square by 2 into X square plus A square over power 3 by 2. And here mu naught is a permeability of free space 4 pi into 10 power minus 7, and N means number of turns in the coil, and I means current passing through the coil, and A means radius of the coil. We measure the radius of the coil, the circumference, 2 into X square. X means distance of the center of the coil to the place of reflection magnetometer. This distance is called as an X, and A is radius of the coil. Substituting all the values at several points, we are getting the magnetic induction theoretically by this formula, experimentally by this formula. We should change the X values at several distances and note the respective angles in east side as well as in west side. So east side at several distances, X is equal to 0, X is equal to 0.6, 0.3, 3 cm, 6 cm, 9 cm, 12 cm, at same distances in the west side also. We can formulate the average of east deflection and west deflection as theta, and so that we can substitute the values, we will calculate B at several points. This is the Stewart-Gies experiment where it gives the measurement of B is equal to B theta. And this same can be experimentally. Now we can show what is the uses of every apparatus and what is the value of calculation. Okay, thank you.
Yes, welcome to the real apparatus. This is battery illuminator where it provides the required amount of current. This is rheostat where it controls the amount of current from the battery illuminator. This is plug key K, where it allows the current through the circuit or will stop the current in the circuit. This is the ammeter, how much current we are sending through the coil we can measure. And this is the commutator, which has four points, these four points. And this is the two plugs where we reverse the current either clockwise or anti-clockwise. That can be done with the commutator. The commutator two point, opposite points are connected to the coil. This is the coil. The number of turns where you have taken the number of turns in these points is mentioned here. Here the number of turns mentioned is 20 number of coils. This is the coil. This is the coil. And in this coil, how many number of turns we are taking? 20 number of turns of a coil is present. And this is the deflection magnetometer. In this black needle is there. That black needle representing that magnetic needle. Perpendicular to that, there is a white needle is there, where it is aluminum pointer. The aluminum pointer is always showing the deflection, and the magnetic needle will affect the magnetic fields, external magnetic fields. Now, this is the arm of a deflection magnetometer. This arm of deflection magnetometer is now showing east and west direction. This is east and this is west direction. And perpendicular to that, there is coil. This coil is showing in north and south direction of the earth. And now the coil is always parallel to the magnetic needle, and the arms are parallel to the aluminum pointer. This is to be adjusted first. After adjusting this one, you can show that aluminum pointer is coincided with 0, 0. So the deflection is now without current through the coil, and there is a zero deflection. Now we will send the current through the coil by just keeping the plug key close. As plug key is closed, here we are observing that deflection is observed in this meter. Where previously it is 0, now it is at a particular value. Suppose it is now at 65 on one side, another side is also 65. So that this 65, this is 65. The two readings are to be noted as theta 1 and theta 2. And mentioned that the deflection magnetometer, center of the deflection magnetometer is at zero distance of the coil, means at the center of the coil. Now X is equal to 0 in the table. X is equal to 0, first point. Second point is theta 1 and theta 2. Now we will reverse the current direction in commutator. So these two points, commutator points, is now removed like this and put in this direction. So the current through the coil is passing in reverse direction like this. Hence, the deflection is also get reversed, and note this deflection as theta 3 and theta 4. So, for x is equal to 0, we have noted theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4. That 4 readings are to be noted in the table. After that, you can open the plug like this. After open the plug, you can take this deflection magnetometer to a east side for 3 cm distance by moving this stand slowly. So like this, we can see here and move this point. Now it is what distance? This is 0 and it is at 3 cm distance. Now x is equal to 3 cm. As x is equal to 3 cm, close plug key K here. And as closing the plug key K, we have observed deflection here. And note that deflection is theta 1 and theta 2. At distance x 3, you can note theta 1, theta 2. And reverse the direction of the current with the help of commutator like this. And note theta 3, theta 4. After completion of 3 cm distance, open the plug like this and move this stand to a 6 cm distance and close the plug. And once again, note the deflection theta 1, theta 2 and reverse the current through the commutator and once again note theta 3, theta 4. So 6, 9, 12. After completion of 3, 6, 9, 12 on the east side, you take the same deflection magnetometer into the west side like this. This is 3 cm on west side. And put note the 3 cm distance theta 1, theta 2 and theta 3, theta 4 at 3 cm in the west table. And open and take this one to 6 cm on the west and close the plug key. Every time while you are moving the deflection magnetometer, you open the plug key and do the experiment, noting the theta 1, theta 2 and reverse these plugs and theta 3, theta 4. Like that every time you can do for 6, 9, 12. After completion of the same distances of east, 6, 9, 3, 6, 9, 12 and west side also 3, 6, 9, 12. We will take the average of east, average of west and total values are to be averaged. We get theta and B is equal to BE tan theta as we explained previously. And also we can calculate theoretically B is equal to mu naught Ni square by 2 into x square plus a square whole power 3 by 2 by 2 formulas. We are getting that equal values almost all. This is experimental value B is equal to B tan theta is getting equal to the theoretical value B is equal to mu naught Ni a square by 2 into x square plus a square. Like that we can prove that this one. And we will also draw the graph and from the graph we will calculate BE also by noting that tan theta is equal to 1. Okay. This is the procedure of doing this experiment. And what is this experiment proves? The current coil carrying conductor produces magnetic field around to that point. That is called as a basic principle of this experiment. Okay, thank you.